Odd. Summer got off to a snowy start in Colorado. Mountains west of Denver were already under snow Friday when summer officially began. New snow then started to come down, with the city of Steamboat Springs getting another 20 inches. A wintry weather advisory is in effect until tomorrow morning. Forecasters say new fall is rare this time of year, even in the mountains. 20 inches, June, I'm trying to make that make sense.
Yeah, well, you know, Colorado, weather anywhere past about like September 1st, you know, forget about it because things are going to be changing so much. But this is very rare to be able to see this. And a friend of mine from Topeka West High School who lives in and around Denver, Dawn Sherman, she was complaining about the fact that, you know, it was 53 degrees on the first day of summer. And I said, hey, we'll come out and house sit if you want to trade places.
I will take the 80s, the humidity, I'll take it all.
Yeah, she was not forthcoming on making its way here. Plus, she wanted a pool in the backyard, and I don't have one. We don't have one here at the station. So, you know, what do you do? So, but the offer's open, Dawn, so you never can tell when that might come in handy. Right now, we're looking at those thunderstorms dwindling, at least what is left of them, and then possibility of a few of them popping up as we go into overnight, but mainly looking at things decently quiet for right now. Mainly seeing the thunderstorms for the time being, the ones that are a little bit more powerful back out into eastern Arkansas and northern parts of northwestern Arkansas, eastern Oklahoma, and that moving up into parts of Missouri. Our thunderstorms from the last several hours, not seeing any problem from that. Now, again, we do have a few thunderstorms back to the west of us, but if anything doesn't develop to the east of that line, it's not going to be too much of any problems here in the mid-south area, so good news on there. But a repeat performance as we go into tomorrow, maybe even the possibility of some severe weather. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. Still pretty sultry out there, upper 70s, U of M Earth Sciences, one of the coolest spots in the mid-south right now, upper 70s to lower 80s, and heat index numbers, it still feels like it's in the lower 90s in parts of the area and will continue to be that way overnight. Low temperatures into around daybreak tomorrow morning, only into the mid to upper 70s with that southwesterly winds continuing across much of the area. Now, early tomorrow morning, there might be the possibility of a stray shower or thunderstorm northeast Arkansas through northwest Tennessee. That possibility will be coming and going as we go throughout the rest of the morning and then really starting to pick up a little bit more into the afternoon. And most of that chance will be along and north of I-40. But if you live around, say, Dyersburg, the Boot Heel, north of Jonesboro, that's where you'll see the best possibility. Now, through tomorrow evening, the thunderstorms that you're watching out west tonight and early tomorrow, what's left of them could be passing through the mid-south as we go into tomorrow afternoon and evening, hopefully, again, rapidly dwindling. Threat for severe weather basically over, a marginal threat into the rest of the forecast for today. But we will see, again, the potential of more chances of severe weather as we go into tomorrow, back to our west and then moving into the mid-south as we get into tomorrow afternoon and evening. Again, something to watch out for, and a very steamy one at that, with numbers back in the lower to mid-90s. Possibility of another heat advisory tomorrow, so keep it tuned to News Channel 3 for more on that. Widespread chances of showers and thunderstorms on Monday, little less on Tuesday, and temperatures, again, with the clouds and the rainfall blocking out a little bit more of the sunshine, will be closer to normal in the high 80s to right about 90 degrees. But that's the way it's going to stay over the next few days. So if you have any outdoor plans, it's going to be steamy, humid, hot. It's also going to see the possibility of more showers and thunderstorms out there. Not great chances, but again, if you are going to be outdoors, and a lot of outdoor events are going on right now, swimming lessons, camp for the kids, vacation Bible school, definitely want to check it out with the forecast on News Channel 3, and we'll keep you updated on those potentials of rainfall as we go throughout what's left of June. So something to think about as you're going to be out there with the hot and humid weather continuing.
Yeah, looks like a lot to keep your eye on.
Just about, yeah.
All right, thanks, Austen. Still coming, sports, the Grizzlies' first rounder takes part in